Hello and welcome to Dena Talks DNA episode 2. Today we're going to be talking about variants versus mutation. In recent years, the science community has really tried to distance ourselves from the word mutation because of the negative stigma attached. Instead, we use the word pathogenic variant. But that can be a little confusing. So for the purposes of this video, I'm going to use both to describe what they are.
As I said in the last video, there's no right or correct version of any gene. There are lots of variations among humans, which is what makes us all different. Since scientists have studied many people's genetic codes, we know what versions are normal variation. This is a general consensus of many people's genetic codes that the labs use as a reference. Anytime we find something different than what is expected, known, or common, it's called a genetic variant. If this new version of the gene doesn't change the end product, meaning it does the same job as the normal versions, then it doesn't impact our health. We call it a benign variant, which is just a less common, normal version of the same gene. If this version of the gene creates a different end product, it's called pathogenic. The word mutation refers to a pathogenic variant because it changes the function of the gene, which can go on to cause disease or differences. Many times we'll see a new version of a gene and we don't actually know what it does. We call this a variant of unknown or uncertain significance, or VUS. As we test more people, we learn more and more about the significance of these different versions of the same gene. Over time, as knowledge and technology improves, they may be reclassified, which is why it's important to test with a genetic counselor who can keep you updated on your results.
In later videos, we'll talk more about what it means for you if you get one of these results on a genetic test. But for now, tune in every Friday for new episodes of Dena Talks DNA on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok.